All right, so here's the next Halloween themed thing that I'm going to show you something about. So this is the Doom, the board game of the Doom 3 that was released around in the early 2000s. So this is one of the complete packages that I still have, and it doesn't have the expansion, but the original game doesn't have an expansion either, so this is basically the complete package. Here you can kind of see what it includes. So it has pretty much everything in it that came with the original game, and it's related to some Halloween stuff. So let's see. I originally bought it from a game store called Fantasia Pelit. So this is the original package that I bought it in, I think. So here's a bottle of Möfö or AS. So this is like a regular canister. So you can see kind of like what the size of this thing really is like compared to the canister that you have here. So it's not, well, it is a lot bigger than a regular game cartridge package. So let's just open this up and see what's inside here. There was a gray box here, and then you got the rule book. Here you can play different scenarios. Too bad that it's all written in English. And even though it has colored maps and descriptions, I basically kind of bought this so that you can play other games on it. It has like this scenario things that you need to kind of position the things in certain ways and stuff. At least it's colored, colored stuff here. So yeah, there's some little bit of value to this. So let's see, let's take that. So this is a instruction manual. These are kind of slippery pages, so it's hard for me with the slippery gloves to move around. I think, yeah, these are the basic monsters that were in the first game without the expansion set and stuff. So there is an expansion to this board game also, but I don't have that one. Here you have like explanations of what's gonna happen when you do X, Y, and Z, and it's the typical kind of stuff. Now I got some little packages of here. You get like reference. All the players can have these reference tables that shows you basically this doesn't sharpen the fucking image again. Sorry if the quality is shit because the camera doesn't do the automatic. Here you see, you can basically see what dice do you throw. There's different attack sizes. What do you throw and what do they do? And kind of like their health and health and okay, let's see, armor, yeah, and stuff like that. So this is one of the tile sets. So you could basically, these are measured so that you could basically use any kind of square based, like 2.5 times 2.5 millimeter or centimeter. You could use any kind of like Dungeons and Dragons or Warhammer, Reaper, whatever miniatures you got. And you could kind of like use these maps also for those games. They have this kind of like this, they're kind of like this pretty sturdy stuff that they have this printing on them that there's kind of like this, kind of like looks like it's waterproof. It has this plastic kind of thing on them. So you can assemble the parts. They have this kind of puzzle. Fuck, I'm spitting on my camera. Typical. This puzzle kind of pieces that they fit together, so you can basically make them into a lot of different forms. And these are kind of like the walls. But of course, it doesn't have the walls. But of course, if you wanna make some walls to these kind of games, then sure, you can make the dungeons look a lot better if you want to. I have some stuff like that that I could make the walls from if I would really want to make walls for these kind of games. So yeah, you can build these pieces, and then there's like a few different, like same kind of walls also, and there's like a open wall, and there's some textures like blood splatters, and it looks darker in the original. I'm talking about the fucking camera making it a little bit too bright, but bright at least is good because you can see what I'm showing you. So yeah, the other side, you could basically also almost paint something in here, like another map tile here if you wanna get creative. And then you got, I have made all these are self-made packages that basically have different monsters in different packs. So they have some shitty kind of like black paint on them, but I haven't finished any of them, but I just sprayed some crappiness on them once in a while, but they have a different kind of like basic color. Was it maybe four different kind of colors, the typical main colors, and then you got like all kinds of monsters. Let me see if I have the more finished painting in somewhere. They were originally all gray, and they, I got some paints that I've used to some of this. These paints are actually from the 90s. They are from my own old 90s when I was making these miniature airplanes and stuff like that. So these are really old, but you could use these still on those things if you would want to. So this is like, these are like close to 30 years old at least or something. But if they're all oil-based miniature paints, then basically you could store them for a long, long time. Then you got these different kind of dices that have this ammo values and stuff. So this game really doesn't roll any kind of regular dices. They have this own mechanics on here. Oh, here's probably a mancubus. Too bad that the zoom is better if it's far away. So this is, it has some painting on it. I'm sorry if it's really shitty quality, because this fucking thing doesn't zoom correctly. I need to kind of aim it, and then I need to manually press something to. But it has a lot of details, and it has the, like the, you can't see it, but fucking hell, it has that, like that black background paint that makes the metallic shine and pop out of the model. If you could see this in higher quality, then you could see the detail. So yeah, when you make the paintings real well, this actually starts to look pretty cool. And let me see. Yeah, okay, so the skin color is not really colored except that it's gray. Yeah, so gray, it's made into gray, not the kind of purple that you would have in the original game. I can't remember how it looked like in this Doom 3, so maybe it looked like this. So this character also is kind of like a fat ass. It takes like a, it takes like 2x2 slots of space. So that's how you have to basically play on it. It's a bigger monster, kind of like some kind of beholder or something. I'm not sure how that big, maybe that could be like 3x3 D&D dungeon crawler figure, but it's a bigger monster than only those regular sizes. Then you go to like, this is like the smallest block that you have in this game. It's like 2x1. And then you got different kind of pieces, like, let me see how fast I should show these things. Try to open them, but it's hard with one glove that's slippery as shit. Like, let me see if I can show you a little bit. Like, all the items have this one square size thing in here that they take like one slot, and they have their own things that you can place on the map. And let me see. I can't seem to be able to open this package correctly. Yeah, no, the doors have this different separate kind of things that if there's a door here, then you can put a kind of this like this cheap stand door in there. That's the different part, that it doesn't have the walls, but it has the doors. And then these are kind of like ventilation shafts that you can place. They have prints on both sides, so basically you could put it here. And then I think you can transform the spiders at least through these, so that you can attack as the game master. There's some neat tricks in the game that I remember a little bit. Then you got like corrosive acid poison pools. Shit, I dropped it somewhere. Well, fuck it. I'm gonna check out the setup later on. So, let me just crawl back here. I need to be crawling, like in Linkin Park. So, I'm picking up the stuff with better precision if I'm doing this like this. So, okay, so I'm gonna show you a little bit more close by. Sorry if this is such a newbie amateur stuff. But basically, some of the pieces they used so that... Now, on the other side you got like this ventilation shaft, but the other side you got a explosive barrel, so you could use it either way around. And then you can place it on one of these. So now there's a barrel here that you can blow up and shoot shit with, just like in the Doom games. Oh yeah. So let's see, was there anything else interesting in here that is kind of different looking than the regular pieces? Because you can probably go online and see how these pieces look like if you really want to. Okay, so there's a shaft and then there's a teleport kind of thing here. And let's see one thing. And then there's some kind of self-made piece that says 50. On the other side it's a cereal package. I don't even remember what this is, but it says 50. So I wonder why it says 50. I think this is one of the self-made damage markers for some kind of thing. So you kind of get creative when you play with these miniatures. Tabletop war game things that I was playing. I've been interested in these a long time. So there's a health symbol that has health on the both sides, and then the ammo and armor and stuff, weapons, they're like taking another space like this. And then I could, that's another package here. And then there's a package full of doors. And then there's like this big package of these big monsters here. Let's see if there's any one of these colored ones here. Or do they all have that shitty coloring? Okay, I think it's a Baron of Hell or something. It's not colored, but I have this basic black color. It's you can see that it has green and blue on the background, so that I can't see the colored one now. There was that. Okay, was this the one? Yeah, I think this is one of the Barons of Hell that has coloring on it. At least you can't see because it doesn't fucking sharpen the fucking thing, but it has a like red in the eyes, and it has glowing metallic teeth, and you know, it has this tone on the painting. Let's see, yeah, it has even like some nail polisher going on in there. So, and you can see the muscles a little better when there's this black background thing. And also some of the monsters are small, like Imp and Zombie and Spider are one round square, but this is basically like a 2x2. So this is a big monster also, just like it is in the game pretty much. It's one of the finished threat covers. It's not completely finished, but it looks better than the not painted. They look messy crap, like messy garbage. So here you got a lot of this. You also got these cards in the game that you use for actions. They have like this that show what's gonna happen and stuff. I don't want to open the pack with one hand, but you use partially the cards to do things in the game. And then you got different dices, different colors doing different effects. And there's a slight amount of RNG involved. And then you got different pieces to basically build different kind of like hallways and stuff. Unfortunately, it's all pretty much this gray military complex stuff, so that's kind of like the unfortunate part. But you got quite a lot of pieces, and you could paint another place on the other side if you want to. But it's kind of like this grayness everywhere. But I think there's more of the cards than only one pack. And then you have advertisements from the early 2000s. And even got some paintbrush here that I have forsaken there somehow. And I'm not exactly sure if every possible piece is in the pack, but let me see one thing. And there was at least like some kind of, yeah, like some kind of, you can play this on the four player multiplayer, so you can have four player, up to four player, I think, just like in Brutal Doom nowadays in our games. Here you have like some kind of like a player board where you see what kind of health and armor and ammo and stuff you have on your character. You can see the elements going down in there. I don't want to use this too much because, okay, so there you got like a player card. Prepare Uranus, so you got like these actions with the same company logo as that game has. I don't remember exactly what kind of cards it includes, but there's a all the basic things, some kind of basic things that you can do in the game, that they have their separate action cards. But it's kind of like a simple game, so here you got some writings of mine, I think. I'm too young to die, hey, not too rough, two wands, two ammo, invader. Art me playing the stars and... Okay, so this is basically... It's like a save game for a board game. So basically if you start some kind of game like Dungeons and Dragons or some other game where you play in multiplayer and one of them players is Dungeon Master or something, then you can manually save in the games. If you wanna quit the game and start playing again, you can basically save so that you make these papers that show everybody's position and what they have in inventory and where's the status of the game and stuff. And that's how you kind of save in these old games, these board games. So this is part of the save files. I had more of this kind of stuff here somewhere also. So it's that's one way to save in the old games. But we didn't really play this game much, but this game is kind of like more dices, I think. You could use these pieces to almost any kind of miniature game. So that's kind of like, you could reuse these things for a lot of things. So let me show you one thing. I'm gonna be back. Now I'm really into all kind of games and miniature games and stuff. So let me show you a little bit something. Like this block here is the kind of foam that you build stuff like walls into these games. So if you would build a ground from this, then you could build floor walls to dungeons from this kind of foam thing. I bought this from some place that has these miniature stuffs in sale. But I still haven't figured out what to do from this, but it needs a lot of crafting skills and, you know, nerdy miniature building before you can take advantage of this stuff. And you can also use, you can use some Quake hammer here, LARP style. So either you go to real life LARPing, or maybe you can kind of like ban swing characters off the board with this kind of weapon that I have here. Oh yeah, so yeah, I'm into all that kind of stuff, gaming kind of like the way you want to. So I don't think I can really show much more about this. I haven't painted much of these figures, but they all fit into this garbage bin here. So once upon a time I bought this because I thought it looked kind of cool and stuff, and I have some more other figures also, Warhammer and those Bones figures by Reaper, but they're also not very finished, and I also have all my self-made miniature figures that I'm not gonna show you right now, but I'm into this kind of stuff, so if I make some more videos about this kind of stuff, then you know where I'm coming from. So, and nowadays we are also playing a lot of the Doom mods in multiplayer mode, and maybe we could play some Doom RPG, Dungeons and Dragons kind of stuff in some physical form like this board game sometime. So just need to see if that's possible or what's gonna happen. But I just try to show you something that I have a bunch of stuff like this. So this fits to the Halloween theme and theme. And so yeah, so thought I kind of showed you a little bit. This is kind of like from the Quake. In Quake 1 you got this stuff. But anyway, I don't know what else to say about this. I don't want to make too long videos because the uploading is too painful on my garbage computer, unfortunately. So yeah, I'm gonna make some little bit more similar videos in the coming times. So yeah, I don't know what else to say. So thanks for watching and stay tuned for more. Unfortunately, I think I flipped my camera, so sorry if this is the other way around, but this is how it is on my laboratory. So thanks.